was mocking her and only saying, yes, ma'am, yes, church. And she was like, you want to be me? No, sir. Not my thing at all. But last week, so the bishop came and he said, Sister Christian, you know that you're giving the word. I said, what, sir? And I just started to laugh because this is not my part at all. However, if the Lord says so, then I have to answer the call. So, I was 3 weeks, 3 nights, 3 evenings, I could not have any dinner. I could not eat. I had to turn some sore throat, just injured, and had something in my stomach. I don't know how this, I don't know why a person is run after wanting to be preached and to be pastor, because it is not that easy task. It's something that's very, very serious when it comes to delivering the word. And I remember I never even said anything to my local church family. I never said anything to Karen. I never said anything to Natalie, Missionary William. I said nothing to nobody except Rockton and Hope, because I could not get this word alone. And I remember calling some of my friends, local and international. I said, I don't know what this I've got myself into, but y'all need to be praying for me. But I fasted and I prayed and Monday nothing. Tuesday, no Jesus. I will call Bishop and tell him, sir, this doesn't seem as if I don't want to be doing it, because I've got nothing. I've looked through some of the notes that I've given. I've studied the Bible and nothing connected. And then on Thursday morning I was praying and I drifted off somewhere. I don't know where I went. And something came to me about the Tower of Babel. And I prayed at the well. I don't know if I have preached that. I don't know. I came home Thursday evening when we went to class after I was at her house and I was alone. And I said, Jesus, you have to confirm this to me, because I will not go there and say anything until I'm sure it is you. I went to the veranda, not even a minute after, took up Daddy's Bible that I took him off the business center. I opened it up and I said, oh, this is a thing I have, study Bible. That enough to read, so, you know, has good Bibles and sit again, saw a signature, sit again and I saw a sheet of paper. Dated 2016 and the exact scripture. I say, okay then. Alright, this is it. So I'm going to time is for a spring. And I am so happy. I was really hoping that the Holy Ghost would just take over and I would not be free. Yesterday, Bishop was trying to get me, I couldn't get me, and he was like, Sacristan, I saw Mr. Reza come and who was interviewing you, because I was calling your phone household and no answer. Why was Bishop? I was under pressure. I was praying, I wasn't paying any money, any man, I just locked away. So when he called, I was like, yes, Bishop, he said that some visitors are coming, that won't have to be. That was not the case, Brendan, that was not the case. But anyways, we read from Genesis chapter 11. From verses 1 to verse 9, and it reads, and the whole earth was of one language and of one speech. And it came to pass that they journeyed from the east, and they found a plain in the land of Shinar, and they dwelt there. And they said one to another, go to, let us make brick and burn them thoroughly. And they had brick for stone, and they had slime for mortar. And they said, go to, let us build us the city. Of a city and a tower, and let us make a name, lest we be scattered abroad upon the face of the earth. And the Lord came down to see the city and the tower the church, that the children of men had built. And the Lord said, behold, the people is one, and they have all one language. And this they began to do. And now nothing will be restrained from them which they have imagined to do. Go to, let us go down. And they confound their language, that they may not understand one another's speech. So the Lord scattered them abroad from thence upon the face of all the earth, and they left off to build the city. Therefore, this is the name of it called Babel, because the Lord there confound their language of all the earth, and from thence did the Lord scatter them abroad upon the face of the earth. And our bishop has taught us well, and you've noticed that all the verses begin, with the exception of 1789, with as. And as you suggest that this me to get the proper context. And the topic, I couldn't even find a topic for it. So many things were coming, I didn't even know how to coin a topic, the topic for today. You cannot fight against God and win.
Amen.
This event was preceded by the flooding of the entire earth. The only survivors was Noah and his family, and this can be seen in Genesis chapter 7 and chapter 8 as well. According to Genesis chapter 7, it reads for 40 days and 40 nights. All the highest hills and the mountains were submerged underwater. And as a result, all life, whether it be air, land, sea, under the earth, everything died except for Noah and his family. According to biblical numerology, the number 40 represents a period of probation or judgment.
Yes.
And it's a means of God humbling his people for their transgressions against his command.
Yes.
If we think that was bad enough, the earth remained in a flooded state for 150 days. Just recently, the Carolinas have been affected by hurricane, Florence. And even up to now, the rivers have not peaked, because after all that rainfall, it takes a time to get from the mountain top to settle where it can be collected. So they are still having serious troubles there. The place is ponding, one huge pond. They cannot do anything, and the number of deaths is increasing. The flood was not only from the rains above, but the Lord opened the aquifers of the earth. So there was no escape. I'm a geographer, so there was no infiltration could not take place. Through flow could not take place. Surface runoff could not take place, because God said everything must die because of your transgression against me. The earth was baptized. He had to cleanse it again, because man had disobeyed his transgression. That is why I cannot understand when persons refuse the baptism in Jesus' name, because they must be born again. There must be a cleansing. When the flood ended and the ark rested, it rested on Mount Ararat. There came a point where they had to leave. And in Genesis chapter 9, verse 1, the Lord blessed Noah and his family, and he gave them a command. Be fruitful and multiply and replenish the earth. The word replenish there can be substituted with fill the earth. That was his command. When God gives a command, he knows exactly what he's doing. And it makes no sense in order to query or, well, you can ask, you know, but even after asking and even after struggling, it is best to follow his command. So chapter 11 says that it came to pass. And they journeyed, and they found a place in the land of Shinar, and they dwelt there. First wrong step. From Mount Ararat to Shinar is approximately 480 miles. That was kilometers. I'm not too sure. Just give me a second. I think it was miles. Yes, miles. I'm a journalist. So I went to the scale and I measured it, because I wanted to see how far they had got before they decided that they wanted to stop and dwell. Chapter verse 2 says, they found a land, a plain in the land of Shinar. A plain is an extensive area of flat land.
Yes.
That is broad, and it's usually covered by fertile soil, nutrient-rich soil that has been settling there because of rainfall and erosion and removal of topsoil. And after that flood, that area would have been packed with nutrient-rich soil.
Yes.
Perfect for agriculture. It was a nice place to live. In geographical terms, from a geographical standpoint, there was absolutely nothing wrong with them wanting to settle there, with them choosing to establish a city there. It was perfect. It was flat. It was easy to construct any building there. It was a well-watered place. I forgot to do that in speech. That's it. Right? And it was well drained, it was well watered by two major rivers, River Euphrates and the Tigris River. It was a coast that town was close to the Gulf of Persia.
Yes.
So they had a lot of resources to access where they could survive on their own, but that was not the command of God. God said, go forth, be fruitful, multiply, and fill the earth. You cannot fill what you have not occupied.
Yes.
You must go there to fill the place to occupy. Right? So they disobeyed. They wanted to stay there, and there is nothing wrong with it. It was wise, because they are people of God. So it was wisdom to choose that location. But the problem came in their disobedience to God's command. Shinar is the old name for southern Babylonia.
Yes.
So maybe it was in English, right? Can I mention it? Right? I prefer that. My apologies. Shinar was the old name for southern Babylonia. It is sometimes used interchangeably with Babylon. Babylon was the Hebrew word which meant confusion. It was described as a city of pride and idolatry.
Yes.
Timnahay says the tower, or let me just call that there. Right. Bear with me.
Right.
So they found Shinar. They saw the beauty and the prosperity and the resources it had, and they said that they knew more than God, so they were to stay there, they were to dwell. And he continues to say, and they said one to another, there's a conversation taking place.
Yes.
Let us make brick.
Yes.
Burn them thoroughly.
Yes.
We have stone for bricks and slime for mortar. He continues and said, let us build us a city and a tower. Whose top may reach up to heaven. Maybe let us make us a name, lest we be scattered upon the face of the earth. Where did this deception come from? There had to be a leader. Every community of people has a leader. Where did this deception come from? So I said, Lord, who was the leader of this time? And I had to go back again to Genesis chapter 10. And the beginning of his kingdom was Babel. Let me, verse 9. And Cush begat Nimrod, verse 8. So he began to be a mighty one in the earth. He was a mighty hunter before the Lord. Wherefore he said, even as Nimrod the mighty hunter before the Lord. Dr. David Livingstone said that this translation was a much milder version than what it was actually supposed to be. It should have read that Nimrod was a tyrant.
Yes.
And he went about opposing the Lord, creating tyranny, led the people astray from God.
Yes.
But in translation, they opted for the milder version. And the beginning of his kingdom was Babel and Erech. And Achan and Calvin in the land of Shinar. And out of that, that went for Asher, and he builded Nineveh. So it's familiar?
Yes.
What do we know about Nineveh? And the city of Rehoboth and Calah. So it's established here that Nimrod was their leader. But before we go to Nimrod, let us, they kept saying, let us.
Yes.
Let us without God in it is filled with pride.
Yes.
It's all about me, what I want. So let us examine the method. Let us, you will build bricks. Let us build a city. Let us burn them. They're smart enough, because burning the brick would make them more durable, and that is why no one today they can still be found remnants of the tower of Babel. So they were wise, they weren't fools, because they were made in the image and the likeness of God.
Yes.
Next one said, let us build us a city and a tower.
Yes.
A city in and of itself, building a city is not an unwise thing, but what was wrong, they stopped it. They were supposed and what was that message? It is rooted in the Hebrew word gada, to be or to make large. They wanted to pump up themselves.
Yes.
They wanted to make themselves large on the earth.
Yes.
A pulpit is a raised platform from a church from which preachers deliver their sermons.
Yes.
They wanted the tower to reach up to heaven. They wanted their pulpit to go to heaven. Why?
Send God a message.
Why? The building of the tower was a sign that they did not believe God. After the flood, the Lord made a covenant with Noah. He put a boat in the sky. He said, I will not destroy this earth again. They did not believe. They didn't believe. So they, in their mind, we are going to con God. We are going to outsmart God. We are going to build us a tower high up on the top of the heaven.
Hallelujah.
We are going to give him credit, so they use that money. great grandson of Noah, the grandson of Ham, the son of Cush. He was a Cushite. Great grandson of Noah. Then how come? Where did this come from? But if you remember to read on between chapters 9, 10, and 11, you realize that after they had settled, Noah was a husbandman for a vineyard. Papa Noah got drunk. And half his son saw his
making this.
So there's a whole lot of debate as to what the making this referred to. Why that makes us bad. What I want to be born, whatever the making this was, Ham went against his father's God-given parental right. Saw his father's making whatever it represented. And then went to expose his father's making by telling his brother. Children, your parents have a God-given responsibility before you. It is the first commandment with promise. And children here, even refers to those who are of adult age and you are unmarried, myself for example. You are still under. Because there must be somebody leading you, you are still under the coverage of your parents.
Yes.
If you pick something, even whether you are under reference to persons who are spirits who are saved or unsaved, that's a God-given responsibility. Children, do not disobey your parents. It's the first commandment with promise. What is the promise? Long life. What am I telling others? You did that. First commandment with promise. So, Grandfather Ham set a bad precedent. Parents, be careful of the example you set for your children. You plant a seed that will grow. Yes. When Ham exposed Noah's nakedness, he cursed his poor son, Cain, and said, "You'll be a servant of our servant."
Yes.
What a situation to look for when you didn't even do anything. Because of parents. So, Nimrod is coming from that land where he learned to disobey the command, this authority to place over his life. So, he was a Cushite. His name meant rebellion, according to Hitchcock's Bible Dictionary. According to Smith's Bible Dictionary, his name meant rebellion. He was valiant, he was bold, he was bad. He was fearless, too fearless. He was courageous and he was daring. He established his kingdom beginning in China and expanded northward. He established Babylon, which later became the place of enslavement for the children of Israel. He was a great hunter, a prototype that kings followed, as the king was his responsibility to protect his people. In those days, there were a lot of wild beasts, so he would go out and hunt wild beasts, devour them and protect his people. Some Asian scribes say that he was the first world conqueror. Some describe him as a hunter of not only animals, but of also souls. That is a dangerous thing. It has both a literal meaning and a spiritual meaning. He used enslaved persons to serve his purpose. He lived his life in total defiance of God and he preached rebellion and unbelief towards God. He did so in many instances by force. Here is the message. You don't have to do what God says. And you can sing the prosperous, but you cannot fight against God and win. The first two cities he established under his leadership were said to be the first two places where organized false worship took place. And that was along his wife. His wife was something else. Some say that his wife was after his mother. Where there is idolatry, there is a lot of sexual perversion. How could Nimrod turn out this way? How could he? You know, all of this was taking place as great-grandfather Noah was alive. Did he not hear of his predecessors, how they went against God? and what happened to them. Oh! Some say his building was an attempt, the building of the tower was an attempt to seek revenge against God for the ancestors that he lost. Somehow, the people were deceived. Do not fall for the deception. No one deliberately goes into a path that they know they're going to lose, so they had to be deceived somewhat. But let us continue. I'll soon get finished. Don't worry. Verse 4 says, and they said, let us go build us a city and a tower that will stop me from him, and let us make us a name. Hear what they said, oh, lest we be scattered abroad upon the face of the whole earth. Why did they say? They were not completely blameless in falling for the deception. They knew what God had told them. And with that in mind, they decided to follow Nimrod.
Yes.
They said, just in case now, before God can do anything and spread it, make me case and build us a city and build us a tower. You don't have to do what God says. Before God can scatter us, so they knew what God had told them to do. And they still decided to disobey God. You cannot fight against God. This was God's people, you know. This was the people who decided to say, because God said that they were righteous. But they said, lest we be scattered abroad. They knew full well. They went ahead. They behaved as if after God had delivered them and saved them during after that great flood. Can you imagine 40 days or 40 nights of rain from above and below, and then another 150 days? Then what would God do? Just leave you high and dry? Give you nothing in return? They behaved as if God was an unjust God, as if they were his creation of love. That is why he created us now, to show and forth love. Was he going to leave them without any purpose? Was he going to leave them without any power, any authority, any benefit? This was not the case. Because in Genesis chapter 9, verses 2 to 3, God gave them control over everything. He said, I have given of you all things. He said, fear will be the animals because of you. Because you are my children. Somehow, hear the deception. By falling for the deception of Nimrod, the people of God became complicit in the fight against God. They are now being charged as co-conspirators with Nimrod. They may not have conceived it, but they sure enough went along with it. They knew full well what they were doing. This deception is very similar. The instigator in this whole case is the father of all lies, the devil. It's the same kind of lie spinning in the garden of Eden, you know. Jesus gave them everything. Only thing he asked, do not eat of his tree of good and evil. They said, no man, you can't eat of it. You be as wise as God. They wanted to elevate themselves to where God was, and you cannot do that and expect to win. That is why he's God. He sees ahead. You, your wisdom, their skill, their techniques, their abilities to identify that which was good and identify a place that was prosperous, it all came from God. So how are you going to outsmart God? You cannot. Whether you choose to align yourself with God's will or not, you will play a role in establishing his victory. Verse 6 to 8 says, and God steps in. He saw them building. And he didn't literally come down in a bishop talk, was there? He just figured the expression for us to understand that he intervened in the matter.
Yes.
Saw them. Watch them now. Watch them. On a skilled man, let brick and burn it. What a wise man! And God came down. and verse 8. And the Lord said, behold, the people is one, and they all have one language, unity.
Yes.
And this they begin to do, and nothing will be restrained from them, which they have imagined to do. They are his children.
Yes.
They came from the Son of God.
Yes.
God knows the power of imagination.
Yes.
That is why in 2 Corinthians 10, it speaks about our weapons not being physical, but being spiritual, and speaks about casting down imagination.
Yes.
We are of God. We were made in his image and likeness. We are a product of his thought, of his imagination. Yes. This is the deception. You know? Nimrod was imitating God.
Yes.
In the beginning, God said, let us make man. And he came and he made man.
Yes.
And his forcing that thing appeared. Here comes Nimrod.
Yes.
Let us.
Yes.
Let us do that. Whatever him do it, he had to use force and tyranny.
Yes.
So after they fell for the deception, I'm sure by then they must have realized, we made the wrong decision. The same man that they were following is now enslaving them. So they would leave them there working and he went to hunt other places and capture people and bring them into his kingdom, to establish his church, preach his message.
Yes.
That's the deception. That's one of the deceptions. That the enemy makes everything possible. Then he catches you. Then you come in, and next thing you know, you are bound. And it seems as if there is no escape for you. You can't escape. So whether you choose to align yourself with God's will or not, you are playing a role in God's victory because you cannot fight against God and win. You are going to play a role in establishing his will on earth. And that's what the fight is about, you know. God wants his will to be done in earth.
Yes.
The enemy wants the opposite because he's looking for company. The scripture says that hell has enlarged her border. The enemy, the devil, Satan, knows what we are about to reap as a reward if we stay faithful to God. He was there. And the same prayer that got him kicked out of heaven is now resting itself. Nimrod, and Nimrod is leading them astray. So you're either going to be the example of what not to do or of what to do, but either way, whether you allow yourself to be used by the enemy or to be used by God, you are going to play a role in God's victory because you cannot fight against God and win. It is all lies. Do not fall for the deception. God's way is the best way. The song says, the way of the Lord is perfect. It is tried. It's a shield and buckler to those who trust in him. Don't buy into deception, brethren. Do not buy into the deception. It's a lie. What are some of the deception things for the world? Are the time is going? Very clear. There is no such thing as sexual morality. Lie. You can do it to anybody, any number of us, anyway. Not natural. There's only sex is a good thing. The Lord created it. But as usual, the enemy tries to twist the word of God and twist the things that God has made and it entrap us.
Yes.
Same sex. Homosexuality, same sex relationship. But one of them I can't play for man and one I can't play for woman, but that doesn't make sense. Deception. It is okay to seek after the power of okay to seek after other powers because they can do what God cannot do. Or they can do what God can't do. It is a lie. They are not Nimrod. The Nimrod spirit is now trying to entrap the minds of our young people. If you look at how important Tony, you know, you see a lot of our young men being drawn into cults.
Yes.
And occults.
Yes.
About 3 years ago, a young man came to me and said, no, miss. I was approached by this young man who left teaching me. He said, you know, so yes. And he had a particular ring. And he's associated with a well-known group that established themselves on a building, a tower in our town. They are no longer in hiding. And they want me to come and join. I said, you know what I know if you buy? This is not this peanut talking to your own teacher. You better run. Do not go there. You will not be be able to pay the price. You cannot maintain that price. That is why Jesus had to die for us. We cannot pay the price for our sins. Nimrod, I see you coming, but you cannot fight against God and win. Using your position to deceive and abuse our children. Have you been hearing what is happening?
Yes.
Trying to get its young mind to earth to believe that there is no God or else this would not have happened to me.
Yes.
It is a lie. Nimrod, you cannot fight against God and win. Jobs. I can give you the high and the peace that you're looking for. It's a lie. When you get hooked on these drugs, you are out of your mind. You start losing teeth. If you're an alcoholic for years, when you get off, you start to have seizures when you try to wean yourself from it. It is an entrapment. It is a lie. TV ads. Come to us, we can read your past. We will tell you your future.
Mm-hmm.
It is a deception.
Yeah.
You cannot fight that. Read your palm. Where were you when these palms were being constructed? That's why none of them look alike. The fingertips have a different fingerprint. Everybody. How many persons living on earth? I should have checked the online world population statistics, my fellow geographer, Brother Samson. Everybody has a separate fingerprint. You cannot fight against God. And wait. You want to know what the future looks like? Come and join us with Jesus.
Yes.
While I was after leaving you, tell you no, you can't fight against God and win with any. I tell God, apparently you is not for me. When I finished high school, I applied to the only place you is. But I thought that I got through for you. And then he went in so happy, went to the beach, and there was one big excitement this I'm going to be. Went to you, there's no package anyway for me. Somebody called and said, Chris, I never got you. It had to be somebody that I knew who would have known that I had applied to you. They called me to play a prank on me to tell me that I had gotten you and I had gotten you. That was the first, that was following a week of campaign. That was the only survivor left on the youth for that. This is why I stay away from this, because this brings attacks on you.
Yes.
And I said, Lord, me not being this thing again, you know, so in their background. But here's the joke, whether you choose to step up and do what the Lord says, or you choose to stay in the background, anyway, so you may as well come back.
Yes.
Just step up and do it. Wait till you win, kidnap. Twice, 2 years in a row, the same date. Cannot fight again. Everything that happened while I was doing, daddy died, he not step on here, but head up by a good man's 30, was meant to derail me from what God wanted for me. Left, finished doing, did all 3 years, failed no course, no graduation package. It's a lot, but is it serious? Somehow I did all of the courses that my friends did, but still did not get up again. Miss Philadelphia shot 4 grades. That's to go to U of O campus to do additional courses to get through. But you cannot fight against God and win. Whatever the enemy throws at you to derail you, to make you fall for the deception that God does not care, it's a lie. While being unqualified, my head of department went on 8 months leave. I was asked to act in her place without a degree, a diploma trade teacher acting as an HOA. Now the next year, after acting that position with no additional pay, I was promoted to a senior teacher position. And this is a backstory that I really can't tell because I have to use wisdom. But something was happening to him yesterday. Studying to go to you was a fight. I was playing one Sunday night. And Bishop said, if there's anybody interfering with what God has for you, pray now. And I prayed, and the door was open. Some things I cannot say now, because I have to do the Lord showed me, you don't need the qualifications that work, you need to get promotion, because promotion comes from me.
Yes.
So everything that you need, don't they know there is truth in what the Bible says. So now the rich and the famous are freezing their bodies. Just in case later on, because they say things can be stored in the memory of the saints. So just in case later on they find a way, they can be resurrected. Where did that come from? Where did that notion come from? You see, everything comes from God, you know. It is an imitation. Don't fall for it. You cannot fight against God. I'm waiting. So you only need one. YOLO, everybody's going around. YOLO. You don't listen to them. Mark, you don't listen to them. Baby, seven hours. Jaden, I remember when they spoke about the length of the eye. That was so powerful. It rested in me. I didn't know that the eye was so big. But he knows Jaden is a carrier, so he would know how to work it up. Betty Lou, Tevin, Anton, I don't care what you're praying back into. Maggie, Benjamin, Heidi, do not fall for the deception. You cannot fight against God. So God steps in, confound them. The thing that they knew would happen, happened. They had to carry on God's wisdom one way or the other, by force or by choice. He came down, confounded them. Several languages. You cannot communicate. Dr. David Livingstone said, two cities that established organized false worship, Assyria and Babylon. He said the Assyrian spirit was wiped out because they were king, but the Babylon spirit is still lingering. Jamaicans call the policemen Babylon. We have a thing that we don't like, authority. And authority was established by God. You cannot fight against God again. And we are in the last days now. The same way for the one to establish one city, one nation, one tongue. Listen up. What is happening? The one world order. The one world order. The same thing they're trying again. And we know we cannot handle too much power. We self-destruct. We self-destruct. God knows our capacity. Not a bad man, we know. He wants us to have everything, but he knows that at this stage, at this point in time, we just cannot handle it. You cannot fight against God and wait. So, Mr. Nimrod, when you're alone, enticing others, engaging in sexual immorality, and telling them that it's okay. You can have church in one hand and the world in the other one. Be careful. The seed that will bear fruit and you will be held responsible. Amen. I'm not even looking at anybody, Jesus. You cannot fight against God and win. Anybody, if it's even me after today, lose my mind. God forbid it. I start preaching another gospel. Take stone and run me out. Because you cannot fight against God. So, Mr. Nimrod, I know you were the first one to conquer, I know. But there's a problem. You see, you have a lot of things, you have a lot of accomplishments that you should be commended for. They're strange. So, you are the first one to conquer. But the God you're fighting made the world and the universe.
Yes.
Those vanity landsettles cannot fight against God away. Mr. Nimrod, you are known as the hunter of souls. But my Bible says this in the book of Genesis, I love this book, it's in the book of the beginning, that God came down after he had formed man. He blew into man the breath of life, and man became a living soul. So you are a hunter of souls, but my God is the creator of the soul. Not only that, he's now saving souls with love. He gave us the power of choice, and that's how you know that he's the true God. You know, he doesn't need the power of God to be God. He was God before we were created. Before the beginning of time, you are going to know using tyranny and tricks.
Your money.
There's power to the sea. That girl don't need to know that. Easy, what in my
right.
If no, the entire earth was falling, no one is on their own. You think God is afraid of me? A small and a micro price to you in here? He's not intimidated by that. Because you can count the years and the number of years on my head, you know.
Amen. Amen.
Where is that?